Hello, my name is Artur Shevik. Welcome to the second part of the Tickles quick tutorial. In this tutorial I will show you how it works with instances, how it works with debugger. I use this class that I have defined in the first part of this tutorial. I also created another methods. This methods set to instance variables. Yeah. I will not talk about what is the meaning of it, because I do not want to teach how to program with Exoticle, but how to use this tool. And I show in last tutorial how to create instance by using some script in script editor in this transcript window, but I can also create instance from component browser directly. I use this create instance menu item. I can pass parameters to this creation, but there is nothing, so I can just click OK. And now I see so-called object inspector. Object inspector is the visualization of object. What have the object? Object has methods, has variables, and an Exoticle has sub-object. And I can call methods on it, also in GUI. Create invoke. What I get is this result window. So I can just call methods from this object inspector. Okay, we have called the methods. This method has defined and set two object variables, but I cannot see them. What I need for it is to click refresh button. And now I can see my two variables. I can introspect the value of it just by clicking it, but I can also change this value by editing it in this bottom area and accepting it. The second variable is an array. This array is shown as list, but there is also some array inspector, and I can see the key value pairs. And in this array inspector I can also change it. I can create new key and also define this the value. And now I can see that this works, it has changed. And I can also destroy the objects. So there are tools for creating instances, for manipulating it and introspecting it. Now I want to show how to debug, how to use debugger. First I have defined some methods that some has some more content. It defined a local object variable, set a local variable A, and then set the object variable with this local variable. And important is this line of code. It is in the way that I invoke the debugger. You cannot set indeed a breakpoint. You need to program a breakpoint. And the methods bar calls foo. I create an instance. In this instance I use this GUI to call the method bar, and now the debugger window is coming. In this debugger window you can see stack frames, you can see object variables and local variables. I can browse in the stack frames, I can see this procedures or methods that are called, but I can also make changes. I can, for example, change the object variables. I can also, what you probably will not expect, evaluate script in this level of this debugger. In debugging, you can, for example, I can say this will work. I can even change something. Do it. Print it. And finally, I resume this call. And in the result view, I can see that I have got this value that I have changed in debugger. So you can use debugger not only to show to observe how this program works, but you can influence it. In this tutorial, I have talked about object inspector, introspecting variables, changing it, and also about debugger. In next tutorial, I will talk about code repository and version system, built-in version system of TCLSQuick.